Good afternoon, YouTube. Well, we got busy yesterday and made our first ever batch of marmalade. This is a clementine ginger lemon marmalade. I didn't get the proportions of liquid and sugar right. This was inspired by Dale Calder and his Christmas marmalade video. So everybody go show him some love on his channel. I took his recipe, which was for a normal marmalade with normal oranges, and then two recipes that were based on clementine oranges. And I thought that, well, what I should have done was follow a recipe exactly the first couple of times, but I've been making jam for 50 years, just never marmalade. And I thought that these other two clementine marmalade clementine jam recipes had way too much water and way too much sugar in them. Did not occur to me that clementines not only have less pith between the skin and the fruit, they also have less juice and less fruit in relationship to the amount of peel. So they need the extra water and the extra sugar to have enough of the gelatin, the jelly portion of the marmalade. But you'll fix that next time the clementines go on sale. That 3 pints of marmalade cost us about $2 plus the electricity to run the stove.
Yep.
It was about $1 worth of clementines and about $1 worth of sugar. So, in the process of doing that, our coffee maker died.
Bad coffee machine.
So this video is actually about repairing our KitchenAid coffee maker. Of course, the very first thing I thought of...
Hey, can you hear me the filter? Back to the sink. The very first thing I thought of...
was that the filter was clogged. So I pulled it out and you could immediately hear water rush down into the pipe underneath the burner where it gets boiled, and then it slowed back down again. I ran some water through this and it came out the bottom as fast as it went in the top, so the problem is not the filter. I took apart this thing and there were large calcium deposits inside here, but nothing that could be blocking any of the little shower head type holes. I took apart this pipe here. That's not blocked. So the problem has to be between where the water comes up here and where the water goes down there. My bet is the problem is in the pipe that is underneath the heating element. Now, coffee makers do not have a pump in them. I'm mentioning this because every time there's a problem with the coffee maker, my wife tells me she thinks it's a problem with the pump.
And he tells me every time there's no pump.
The weight of the water in the tank makes the water have to run in one direction through the heating tube, and as it heats, it gets pushed up to boil up through the top of the machine and down into the coffee grounds. It is worked simply by temperature and pressure built by temperature. Now, I put an inch of vinegar in the bottom of the machine here and let it sit overnight.
Look to see how this thing comes apart. How? Don't hit your head, babe.
It comes apart with four screws.
Where'd the screwdriver go? We're sitting beside the wrong coffee maker. It's gonna have spares. The rag? The dishcloth? That's the word. It's on a little bit of vinegar leaking out.
It has little clips at the front holding it together. Inside the coffee maker. This here is the heater. That's your boil tube. That is your over temperature switch to prevent the pot from boiling dry and catching fire.
Little
kitchen fires, the orange-handled ones. This has a backflow valve in the middle of the line. That's actually quite unusual for coffee makers.
In my life.
Look at the buildup of calcium on the inside of that. And on the inside of this. You see the calcium in there?
There's no hole.
Well, no, there is a hole, but... Okay, you want to run the brush through that in some water?
Well done. Do it both at the same time. Well done. Here we go.
So what we're going to try to do is to pass a cleaning brush up through and around.
Where am I?
This is the backflow valve. Water trying to flow in the bottom will push that little plastic ball bearing up to block the entrance at the top there, like that. And we'll get back to you as soon as we get these rubber hoses clean. Okay, so now that the wife is back behind the camera, she can tell me if you can see what's going on here.
Stop moving.
So you can see that the ball moves more or less freely. This is the bottom. It's got a cross to prevent the ball from falling out. The top has a circle that the ball
too big for
will block off. That's how the backflow valve works. But these are not present in most coffee makers, in my experience. So, we're going to try to run this little brush. It doesn't like where the hose is crimped at the front there. Got it past the crimp there. Crimped in a little bit by the locked solid behind that or not. But the best way to check that is with vinegar.
Good. Easiest within reach.
I had a bottle of something like CLR, I would use it here. It is allowing liquid to flow, but very slowly. So we're going to leave the vinegar sit in that tube for an hour or so, and we will come back then.
Okay, turn back on, let that go down, and in we go. Oop, too far here.
So it's only been about 20 seconds, and you can see where the vinegar is actually starting to work at the hard water deposit inside that tube and give off carbon dioxide gas. I just wanted to show that because hopefully in an hour it will stop having tried to clean any calcium out and we'll have got us back into usable condition. Okay, so I just dumped the vinegar out, which is now kind of yellow.
Okay.
A couple of chunks of calcium in there. This one has a much larger wire.
Longer wire?
Larger wire.
Oh, okay.
Nope, it doesn't want to go past the crimp on this side either.
Oh, I did try.
Yeah, the wire on that's about twice as big as the wire on this one.
Okay.
Well, it is going past. Only just, but it is going past. Ha!
Bleh. I'm gonna do that.
There is no impediment. And I somehow managed to not get vinegar in my eye doing that.
I was just gonna ask if you wanted to try and get the brush back in through there. No way.
No.
Okay.
Although, probably wipe. That's not very good. I'm gonna grab me a paper towel. Bear, move! Well, you want Mummy to step on you? But you're standing at the door, at the stove. You must be making something good to eat.
Not yet.
Check valve. Check.
Check, check. Sound check, sound check. Motor base ready.
Okay, that one's on. That was easy. I do have a special pair of pliers out in the shop. Well, they're special in that I've modified them to put an offset groove across here, like this, and one offset from each other across there to actually hold these kinds of wires.
Monkey! Went too far! Which reminds me, I want to
check the other one.
That's it, hide it in your hand!
That's special.
No, we didn't check.
Is the tube going up?
Yep. Zero impediment there. All righty.
Should move what? Where is that one?
What?
There it is.
So these, 1, 2, 3, 4, are the clips that were hanging us up, getting it apart, that lock into those 4 loops. Get that one lined up properly, we have to take this one back out.
Ow. Bad monkey. Wow.
since I didn't say it at the start. Warning, electrical shock hazard. Unplug before before failing. Unplug before servicing. Failure to follow these instructions can result in death or electrical shock.
Splashed vinegar everywhere.
Okay, cleans.
Did you want the filter? No, not yet. That should be enough.
First, we'll give it a minute to make sure it isn't sending out little pools of water.
Nothing down below.
Oh, you can see the water level dropping. It is definitely flowing through.
Do that again. Okay, a lot faster than it was.
That is steam being released from in here as it's filling. And you may be asking why we're bothering with this. Well, it is Sunday, yeah, Boxing Day. We live out in the middle of nowhere, and the reserve backup coffee machine is the one from the shop, which I got on a great deal because it doesn't have a timer, and I didn't want one with a timer in the shop. For the coffee to be ready for Tora when she gets up to go to work at 4 o'clock in the morning, we need the timer. If this hadn't worked, I'd be taking apart the other coffee machine and taking the burner out of it and putting it in this one so that we'd still have the timer.
Pushed in all the way?
Pushed in properly. Alright, well, I'm going to call that a win.
Okay.
Normally this is where I would say, that's it for now and thanks for watching, but this time, in the immortal words of Monty Python, now for something completely different.
Uh-oh.